Action.
Welcome to the February edition of Raider News. I'm Cameron Smith.
And I'm Bianca Di Maria.
Let's go check out this month's Teacher of the Month, Mrs. Coleman.
Hello, I'm Cale Rembry, here with our Teacher of the Month, Ms. Coleman. So, Ms. Coleman, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good. So, you won this year's Best Teacher Year Award. Can you please tell us about that?
Yeah, I won the Teacher of the Year Award. I was nominated by a member of the faculty, and it went through a committee, and here I am.
How excited are you?
I'm very excited. It's a great moment.
Mm-hmm. Congratulations, anyway, beside that.
Thank you.
You run SMAC. Tell us about that.
SMAC is the Student Movement Against Cancer, which raises money every year for Relay for Life, which benefits the American Cancer Society. This year is going to be May 16th, and we're very excited about it.
I'm going to try to be there myself. So, tell us about your other involvement with Muse.
Muse is our school's literary magazine, where students publish their own work and they put together their own magazine. And we put it out every year in May or June, depending on how our submissions go.
That's cool. So, you've been an English teacher for 8 years. How do you like it? Do you enjoy being an English teacher for that many years?
I love being an English teacher. It's one of my passions is reading, and one of my passions is writing. So I really enjoy being able to share that with students.
Awesome. So tell us about what you do outside of school.
Outside of school, I'm getting my doctorate right now, which is obviously pretty time consuming. And I like to run and read.
That's awesome. Thank you, Ms. Coleman.
Thank you.
Now back to studio.
Recently, some work was done at our second floor media centers. Let's go check out this month's construction update and see what has been done.
Hello, I'm Matt here with
Steph.
And this is this month's construction update. So as you guys can see here, there's a door here, and it's for the supervisor's office. It wasn't here before, but they just started working on it. And as you can see, a look from here, it's all redone back there. So let's go check it out.
So can you tell us a little bit of what happened here?
Sure. So this area that we're standing in right here used to be the offices of some of the supervisors, but it was all just one big space, and their offices were just divided by filing cabinets. And so the area needed to be renovated. So they emptied out the whole area, and then they added some of the offices on the other side here. So then they built the walls to make separate offices. They redid the floors, they redid the ceilings and the lighting. So now all the supervisors have separate offices, and we're all in one area together.
So how long has this been happening for?
Well, the construction started we started emptying the space around the end of November, and they really started the construction and the demolition, I guess, and then construction beginning of December. So not too long. It's happened pretty quickly.
So how is this benefiting you?
I think, first of all, it allows us space to all work together, so we can all touch base if we need to collaborate on projects. But it also gives us a private office where we can meet with teachers, meet with students, where some of us didn't have that before.
My office used to be across the way over there, and their offices were also across the way, so this is the first opportunity we've had to actually all be together in one space, so we're really excited about that.
Well, that's all the time we got for this. It looks really nice in here, guys. I really like it. Well, see you next time.
For our latest installment of Student of the Month, we have our newest reporter, Amani Nathaniel, on scene with Corinne Bell.
Hi, I'm on location with Corinne Bell this month's Student of the Month. So, Corinne, how does it feel to be Student of the Month?
I'm really excited, actually. I'm so glad that I was, given this opportunity or, award.
So, I know you participate in clubs in the school. So, can you tell me about that?
Yeah, I'm actually the president of GSA, which is the Gay Straight Alliance, and we're going on a field trip on Friday, and it's actually a conference where we talk to other people, and we're representing New Jersey. Also, I'm in BSU, I'm the financial secretary, and I'm the captain of the step team, and I'm also on the dance team. Yeah.
So I know there's something coming up for the step team. There's going to be a competition. Can you tell me about your goals for that competition?
Yeah, this Saturday, actually, February 21st, we're having our home competition at the high school at 2 p.m., and I'm hosting, and I'm also singing the national anthem.
Oh, say that that's our single.
Everyone comes out and supports, and I just hope that we get a lot of support from everyone at the school.
So Corinne does all of this while maintaining a very, very high GPA. So Corinne, can you tell me your top three colleges that you want to go to and why?
Yeah, my top school is Spelman College, and that's in Georgia. And I want to go there because, I don't know, it's really hot there, and I just love that school. Second is probably Stanford. I love the campus. It's beautiful. And my third would probably be the University of Chicago, just because of its academic strengths. I actually did. I got accepted to four schools, and I actually got full rides for three of them.
Okay. Thank you, Corinne. Now back to the studio.
Recently, the Blue Diamond Step Team held a step competition right here in our high school. Let's go check out some highlights from this event.
I'm here with Bianca Di Maria. So Bianca, what was your favorite movie of 2014?
I would have to say my favorite movie was Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
It's a good movie. Why would you say that?
Because it was a good like remake of it, and it was really interesting. It was never boring, and I'm not usually into movies like that, so it was really good.
I'm talking about.
All right, my favorite movie of 2014 was 22 Jump Street.
Think Like a Man by Kevin Hart.
And 22 Jump Street. Salad.
It would have to be Annabelle.
Didn't see it. Why was it good?
I think it was just mostly because I was with my friends when we saw it.
My favorite movie was Gone Girl because it was really intense and provocative.
The Lego Movie.
That was a pretty awesome movie, dude. Why?
Because of how they took the time to make Legos and put them all together and move them all together all at once. Crazy.
Yeah, Will Ferrell's a heck of a guy, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, he's a funny guy.
My favorite movie is The Fault in Our Stars.
My favorite movie of 2014 was The Interview because it was really funny and I got to see Seth Rogen make fun of Kim Jong-un.
Has to be The Lego Movie.
It's a pretty good movie, man. Why do you like it?
Legos, man, a childhood favorite, and they made the movie pretty good.
Chris Pratt, that's what I'm talking about.
Okay, my favorite movie of 2014 was 22 Jump Street because it was funny.
My favorite movie of 2014 would be Think Like a Man 2 because Kevin Hart was in it and he's really funny.
Expelled with Cameron Dallas. That was a good movie. My favorite movie of 2014 was 22 Jump Street because it was really funny.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with Guardians of the Galaxy. That was a great movie, you know. Love the action, love the comedy in it. It was great, you know.
I give a soundtrack too. What about you? What about you, Bob?
I got to go with 22 Jump Street. It was a great sequel.
Yeah, it improved. Andy?
You got to go with Guardians of the Galaxy. Great soundtrack. That's it.
I'm hooked on a feeling, you know what I'm saying?
On February 11th, SBFHS held their annual cabaret night. Let's go see some footage from the event.
Hi, I'm here with Alex Walajewski. So recently, cabaret night was held. Could you just tell me what that is?
Yeah, cabaret night is the second concert for the choirs. It's where we do repertoire only from Broadway musicals and shows. It's really fun, yeah.
It was great. Went really well this year. Probably one of the better ones we've had as of recent.
Okay. I'll be there.
So I hear this was Mr. Figliano's last performance at the high school?
Yes, it is. This will be the last concert, most likely, that Mr. Figliano will be conducting at the high school. He will be conducting us on the music trip to Washington, D.C., but he stepped in while Mrs. Allen was out with her pregnancy. But now kid has been born. She will be back soon enough, so we think he's probably not going to be back to conduct for the spring concert. But we were really glad to have him. He's a great guy, and hopefully he will stick around for as long as he can.
Okay, so did you take part? And if you did, what did you do?
Yeah, I'm in most of the choirs.
Okay, so were you in it?
I was. I did a featured solo, did The Impossible Dream from the Broadway show Man of La Mancha.
Terrible sorrow to run.
For cabaret night, what's also really fun is we have featured soloists, and you know, you audition on a song, and then you and an accompanist will play it.
Basketball, baseball, football, stickball, volleyball, dodgeball, tetherball, kickball. Playing was hell, the worst of all.
In between, like, all the groups, those featured soloists will go, and, you know, everybody just loves it because the department's so talented. And
I long to fly, sail unrestrained. Why is man free and woman chained? Is that my epitaph before?
You know, everybody's just really great, along with, you know, like, the groups being great. But, you know, the featured soloists are really fun, and this year I got to sing one, which was fun for my senior year. So.
The sound of her laughter will sing in your dreams.
So it was a fun time.
All right, I'm glad you had fun. Thank you. Now back to the studio.
Recently, the AV Club held their annual Valentine's Day Film Festival. With us is the winner of the film festival, Isaiah Maxson, who is also our Artist of the Month. Let's go on location with Isaiah.
Hi, I'm on location with Isaiah Maxson, this month's feature artist. So Isaiah, how does it feel?
Feels good.
Yeah. So I know you're working on a short film. Tell us a little bit about
it. Yeah, I made a short film a couple weeks ago about... it featured three students that go here. One's an artist, one's a musician, and the other one's an athlete. And I kind of followed them around a little bit and just captured what they do. And I interviewed them and asked them, you know, certain questions about, you know, why they do it, and put it together and made a little short film.
So where did people see the film? Where did you show it?
Well, it first debuted at the Valentine's Day Film Festival, along with a couple other films that were fun to watch.
How was the festival actually overall?
It was fun. There were some cool films, a lot of really, really, really funny moments, and it was just a fun time.
So are you just into film or other aspects of art do you also take part in?
I'm very into film, but I'm also into music, which is, I guess, considered an art. I play the drums, so.
Thanks, Isaiah. Yeah. Now back to the studio.
On National Signing Day, six SPF athletes signed on to their D1 school for the upcoming school year. Raider News was at the signing to catch the scoop.
Today, February 4th, is National Signing Day for Division I athletes to select sports. And we are lucky enough today to have five students signing.
It feels great knowing that I'm going to be able to like move on and do what I love to do.
Why Georgetown?
The combination of the great athletics and academics and the location in Washington, D.C. is really why I chose it.
Fairfield was just a great fit for me. I like the people there a lot. I like the environment. The academics were good. The tennis overall was really good and just fit me really well.
Has been a tremendous athlete, tremendous worker, tremendous leader for us. Very excited to see that he has the opportunity to play the next level at Wagner. Just having spoken with coaches there, they're very excited to see him there.
What does it mean to you to be a Division I athlete?
It's a dream I've had ever since I've been a little kid. I mean, when I played flag football, I always dreamed of playing Division I football. Now that, you know, I signed, my dreams come true.
It feels really awesome. A lot of hard work comes in store and everything, but I think for now I'm really enjoying becoming a D1 athlete and everything that goes with it.
Unfortunately, we didn't get the opportunity to see the true Jaceem because of an injury that he had on the very first game of the season and was out for 18 games.
I put in a lot of work and I worked really hard to get to this level.
However, when he did come back, he was instrumental in leading the team to the Group 4 state final. So, we hope that you have a rewarding and successful career at Monmouth.
I'm here with Jaceem. So why did you choose Monmouth?
I chose Monmouth because it was a great school for me because it is a good soccer school and a good academic school. So that's, mainly because it's a good soccer school.
It's a great day to be here. It's a great day to be an athletic director when I can watch your children do what they did. With all of you, you're going to be missed.
SPFHS swimming teams finished their seasons on high notes with both male and female teams making it to the state finals and the girls securing a victory. Raider News interviewed one member from each swim team for this installment of Athlete of the Month. Now let's go to Male Athlete.
Hey Raider fans, it's Kadar Carrington and I'm here with Athlete of the Month, Alex Scoo.
Good, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. So talk to me about how you started getting into swimming.
When I was young, I started out at a summer swim club. Nothing much, just private lessons and stuff. And then from there, I went on to the swim team at Willow Grove Swim Club. And then eventually, after that, I went on to the YMCA, and then that stepped into the high school team. And then I'm still on the Y team. So
what was your freshman year like? Talk about, you know, being on the team. What it was like, the experience.
Freshman year was a lot of fun. We made it all the way to the finals. We didn't win, but just being there with all those kids, they were a great bunch of kids, and it was a lot of fun, just like this year. Seniors that year, they really were great leaders, and we tried to mimic that this year also. So freshman year and this year, I think, were the two best years by far.
So coming into your senior campaign, what was going through your mind? How far did you guys think you would make it?
At the beginning of the season, we really weren't sure how far we were going to go. We knew we were going to be better than the last 2 years. But, some of us thought we could make it all the way, but, I mean, no one really had a solidified reason that why we should. But, yeah, we really surprised ourselves with how far we went, and everyone really stepped up the entire year, and that's the main reason how we got so far.
And individually, how do you think you did?
I think I did okay. There were times, of course, where it could have gone a little faster, but it's not really individually. It's just as much a team sport as anything else. It really comes down to relays and everything else, so you needed everyone to win meets and stuff.
And I'll talk about any college plans you have. Do you plan on swimming in college?
Depending where I go, I think I will. I have no clue where I want to go yet. I don't know. It really depends on what school I go to. D3, D1, but I'm not sure yet.
So. Well, that sounds good. Thank you very much, Alex Scoop. And again, that was Athlete of the Month. Back to the studio.
Now let's go to Female Athlete of the Month.
Sam Mahler here with the Female Athlete of the Month, Caroline Cook. Caroline, I'd just like to start off with a congratulations. How does it feel to be honored as Female Athlete of the Month?
Feels great. I definitely think that it's not just for me. I think the whole swim team deserves the honor, and we all did really well this season.
Yeah, you guys certainly had an exceptional year. I understand that you guys won not only your section, but also were crowned as the state champions of New Jersey. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
We were so excited. We knew that we could accomplish it, but only if we worked extra hard and were confident. And when we did, we were just all speechless, so we're all really excited.
Can you tell us a little bit about your emotions as you were crowned state champions?
I didn't know what to feel. I was just so excited, and the whole team was screaming, and it was just an amazing feeling.
All right. And what were some accomplishments that you had individually throughout the year?
I got some personal records. I just improved overall in all of my events.
That's what I like to hear. Improving is the best part. So, Caroline, congratulations on being nominated as Female Athlete of the Month and on winning states. So, thanks for your time.
Now let's go to this month's top 10 plays.
Here are top 10 plays for the month of February on Kobe White.
It's not Peter Yarrum. Let's get it.
Let's start things off right. Who said cheerleading was not a sport? We have Bella Belez with the jump shot. She should have tried out for the basketball team.
All right, at number 9, we got Scotch Plains Fanwood Wrestling taking on Wes Morris at home. George Ramos taking on his opponent. Gets his opponent flipped over onto his back. He's holding him down. Wait for it. Bang, got the pin. Clutch win by George Ramos.
At number 8, we have your very own Mr. Hollywood, Leo Ramos.
Here we go.
Christian with the ball. Uh-oh. Passes it to Dan. Is that Dan Lopez? Uh-oh. Pass it back to Danny. Uh-oh. Here we go. Leo Ramos. Nice little crossover. And one. Golden Dragon.
All right, at number 7, we got some boys swimming action. We got our very own Alex Skoog in the state championship, bringing home the only first place finish for the boys. However, they had a very clutch performance and a great state run. Congrats to the boys swim team.
At number 6, Scotch Plains Fanwood versus Wes Morris. Josh Martin, taking his opponent. Oh, flips him on his back. Uh-oh, Josh Morris dancing. Oh, and with the pin.
And Josh Morris. Look at this man go wild. Look at him. Pumped up.
All right. At number 5, we got freshman Brianna O'Brien lining up.
Hits a 3. Dagger. And look at this. Coming right back. Nearly the same exact play. Makaya swings it to Brianna, and she knocks down another long 2. Look at that form. Ooh. Should have been on the boys' team this year.
At number 4, we have the girls swimming. Stephanie Judge. What a fast butterfly. Oh, wow, she's going fast. I think it's a school record she's going for.
Ooh. All right, at number 3, we got the combined effort by Erica Frazier, Rachel Maezes, Stephanie Judge, and Sarah Davis taking home the first place spot in the 100 relay. Look at these girls fly.
Uh-oh, Leo Ramos should be the number 1 player in Jersey right now. Uh-oh, what a layup. Leo Ramos, Mr. Hollywood, he's not finished. Uh-oh. What is that, a 3? Look at Amendo's face like, man. Okay, he's going again. Oh, Christian, give it to Leo. Whoop, step back. Whoop, swoop. And Amendo's like, man, I wish I could do that.
At number 1, we got another girls swimming action. This is their great celebration. Congratulations to the girls swim team taking home the state championship.
Congratulations, girls. Congratulations.
Great effort whole season.
That wraps it up. With this February's edition of Top 10 Plays, we'll be back.
Check out March for your sports MVPs of the winter.
Ching, ching.
Boom.
We out.
This month for Look at the Past, Patrick Hinkles took a look back at the last time SBF produced the show.
Men,
women, children, welcome to this month's edition of Look at the Past. As you may already know, the Rep Theater is doing a production of Grease. What you may not know is that 15 years earlier, in the year 2000, the Rep Theater also showed Grease. And right now we have a clip of one of the main protagonists, and she's being interviewed. Let's take a look.
Courtney McDonald is the female senior of the month. You may have witnessed some of her talent in this year's musical production of Grease, in which she played the lead, Sandy. Courtney also participates in all elements of chorus, including regions as well as Allstate. Doug Rader went on location with Courtney to find out more. Doug?
Ready? Hi, this is Doug Rader, reporting for 34 News Monthly, and I'm back with this month's female senior of the month, Courtney McDonald. So Courtney, what clubs are you involved in here at the high school?
I'm in the Rep Theater, show choir. I'm the choreographer, all the select choirs, SAD, SLAM, you know, everything, lots of things.
And I recently witnessed a production of Grease twice. I noticed that you were the lead in that. Can you tell me how that went?
It went really well. We were sold out the last two nights. I did all the choreography, and John Corbin, he was like our, you know, best performer.
It was sort of like a race for the lead there between the girls. So who did you have to compete against?
I guess Meryl Betzrutzik, but it wasn't real.
So you had to beat out Meryl Betzrutzik for the lead. All right. And I think you did very well in it.
Thank you.
And what other choir performances do you have coming up?
We have the spring concert in May.
Are there any trips or anything like that?
Yeah, we're leaving for Washington, D.C. this Thursday.
Oh, this Thursday. And when will you be returning?
Sunday night.
And how do you think you'll do down there?
We should do okay.
Yeah, you have any solos?
Yes, two.
You think maybe like an outstanding soloist award might be coming out?
That would be nice.
That would be very nice. Keep your fingers crossed. All right, so what about colleges next year? Have you looked into any?
Yeah, I recently, this weekend, had my audition for Boston Conservatory. I'm looking at a couple others. University of the Arts, University of Hartford. I don't know.
What's your favorite?
Boston Conservatory.
All right, well, I wish you good luck with that and with all your future endeavors and singing and stuff like that. It's just been the female senior of the month, Courtney McDonald, and now back to the studio.
And that wraps it up for the February edition of Raider News.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to tune in next time.
Stay classy, Spiffy.
Oh, that's
great. There's a group picture of you guys, so don't move.
Okay.
Yeah. You gonna take it?
Just chill out there for like another
second. Oh, Cameron.
All right, that's a wrap.
Hi, my name is Billy Wilkins. I'm here with Kevin Westerlin at Scotch Plains Family High School. So, Kevin, how many lunches have you eaten so far today?
Two and a half.
Greater news.
Let's get. Because we have. It's like a super. You know what I'm saying? Lower it so we have. Before it was like.
Tyler, that was so funny.
No, you know what I mean?
Like, did you hear Tyler yell? I bet nobody thought Tyler had that in her, though.
We hit the loop. All right, ready? Go.
Here are our top 10 players for the month of February. I'm Kobe White.
And I'm Peter Yam. Let's get it.
Missed it.
And I'm Peter. Let's get it.
I'm Kobe White. Let's get it.
Oh!
Get it.
Let's get it. Now, I understand you're on this health kick. You want anything you'd like to say about that?
Pretty much, I just eat a lot of food. Yeah.
It's fine. That was good. Again, slow it down a little bit.
Security.
Don't rush. With the girls secure.
I know what you mean.
In 3, 2, 1.
Recently, SPF is...
Can you just swing back
to Laura behind? You're like, shut up! Like...
Alright.
I'm ready for a picture. Thank you.
Make sure it's Cameron, sweet. Schmargendorf.